Today, in the direction of the research in the modern industry, where the research is to be taken, where the scholars is to be work, where the M.Tech student is to be work, where the industry is to be work, of the Indian industry is to be work. Today, Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will give the lecture on this future direction of research in the reverse logistics. Reverse logistics is an important area for the research, and nowadays throughout the worldwide, the research in the reverse logistics are happening, and 80% of the research throughout the world are happening in the case of the reverse logistics. And today we'll understand that the what is the reverse logistics. And today's paper will focus by the Dr. Manoj Kumar on the logistics management, reverse logistics, and the keywords for this paper is the reverse logistics, forward logistics, and the green logistics. Logistics management is known for its complexity, dynamics, and the uncertainty. Many of the lectures of the Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar have come in the case of the logistics management. The advent of the rapid technology development, intense business competition, and changing customer needs and the requirements has forced company to reshape their business model and strategy. Every company have to reshape their business model and strategy. Due to the intense business competition, changing customer needs and the requirement. Customer needs are changing day by day, and the requirement is changing day by day. And that company has to be focused on the customer needs and the requirement. What are the customer needs are there? What are the customer requirements are there? This will be the better business model and the better business strategy for any of the company to understand the customer needs and the customer requirement. Numerous new terms such as a global supply chain, third-party logistics, green logistics, e-logistics, and the reverse logistics are becoming issue that have to be deal with by all companies, local company, multinational company, and the global company. All the type of the company, whatever the companies are there, all company have to be deal and focus on these issue. Any type of the local company, multinational company, and the global company have to focus on the global supply chain, on the third party logistics, on the green logistics, on the e-logistics, and the reverse logistics. And these are becoming the major issue of the research nowadays. Lately, reverse logistic start to be get attention by most of the firms. Many of the multinational company, global company are focusing on the reverse logistics. The purpose of this assignment is to review and identify the clear definition of the reverse logistics. Comprehension of the reverse logistics and forward logistics in order to have a better understanding, and finally future direction of the reverse logistics in gaining the competitive advantage. And in this paper, purpose of the paper is to identify the clear definition of the reverse logistics. What is the reverse logistic up there? Comprehension of the reverse logistics and the forward logistics. In order to have a better understanding and finally future direction of the reverse logistics in the gaining competitive advantage. gaining the competitive advantage. Introduction. There is a growing concern in the area of the supply chain management. One of the important elements of the supply chain which play an important role in cost efficiency management is the logistic component. Cost efficiency management is the important for any of the company. The survival of the company is dependent upon the cost efficiency management. How the company manages the cost, its resources, is important case. Reverse logistics is an issue that has received growing attention in the last decade. In the same time, there are numerous concerns about the environmental issue and the sustainable logistics. In the last decades, throughout the world, reverse logistics and issue which are growing concern throughout the all the company to make the research their company. In the same time, there are numerous concerns about the environmental issue and the sustainable logistics. The concept of the reverse logistics and growth logistics has not been sharply defined, and there is an overlapping in the some definition. Reverse logistics is a systematic process that manages the flow of the products, parts, and information from the point of the consumption to the point of origin by extending a product's traditional life cycle. Reverse logistics is the systematic process that manages the flow of the products, parts, and information from the point of consumption to the point of origin by extending a product's traditional life cycle. Reverse logistics is a growing and important area of the strategic advantage for many of the companies. It is an important area and a strategic advantage, a strategic policy for the many of the companies. Many companies are just beginning to understand the importance of the reverse logistics and start to grapple with the how best to manage their. Reverse logistics. The purpose of this assignment is to review and identify the clear definition of the reverse logistics. Comprehend reverse logistics and the forward logistics in order to have a better understanding and finally future direction of the reverse logistics in gaining competitive advantage. For to gain the competitive advantage, every company have to be go for the reverse logistics. Literature review on the reverse logistics. In order to have a better view and the clear idea for the reverse logistics, let us look at some of the definition the author found in the literature. Define reverse logistics as the collection, transportation, storage, and processing of the discarded products. In say that the reverse logistics is a process which encompasses the logistics activity all the way from used products no longer required by the user to products again usable in the market. Reverse logistics as a process in which a manufacturer systematically accepts previously shipped products or parts from the point or consumption for the possible cycling, remanufacturing, or disposal. Reverse logistics is the task of the recovering discarded products. Course, it may include packaging and the shipping material and the backhauling them to central collection point for either recycling or the remanufacturing. It is the backhauling them to a central collection point for either recycling or the remanufacturing. Reverse logistics are the logistics management skill and activity involved in reducing, managing, and disposing of the hazardous or the non-hazardous waste from the packaging and products. This is the reverse logistics. In reducing, managing, and disposing of the hazardous or the non-hazardous waste from the packaging products, It includes reverse distribution, which causes goods and information to flow in the opposite direction from the normal logistics activity. In coined the term product recovery management to describe reverse logistic as all those activity that encompass the management of all used and discarded products and component and material that fall under the responsibility of the manufacturing company. The objective of PRM is to cover as much of the economic and ecological value as reasonable possible, thereby reducing the ultimate quantity of the waste. Finally, define reverse logistics as the process of planning, implementing, and controlling the efficient cost-effective flow of the raw material in process inventory, finished goods and related information from the point of the consumption to the point of origin for the purpose of the recapturing value or proposal proper disposal. Table 1 represents a summary of the reverse logistics element, which is grouped into what is inputs, activity, output, and from to. These are the reverse logistics element. What is process, task, skill, and activity? Inputs. Inputs are given, activities are given, outputs are given, and from or to are given. Inputs are the discarded products, used product, product parts previously shipped, packaged, and products from the hazard and the non-hazard information, raw material in process inventory. Activity are the management collection, transportation, storage, processing, acceptance, recovering, packaging, shipping, reducing, disposing. Outputs are the products, again, usually reusable, recycling, remanufacturing, disposal, reducing, managing, recapturing value. From point of consumption to the point of origin, central collection point of the manufacturer. These are the reverse logistic elements. Inputs, activities, outputs. What are the inputs are there? What are activities are there? What are outputs are there? What from and to? These are the reverse logistic elements. Considering the elements of these definition, the author believe that the definition given by is the most complete and incomplete the principal characteristics, what we think about the reverse logistic. Reverse logistic also include processing return merchandise due to the damage, seasonal inventory, restock, salvage, recalls, and excess inventory. Additionally, it includes recycling programs, hazard material program, obsolete equipment, disposition, and asset recovery. Based on the integrated supply chain view, there are various components of activity that can be classified under the reverse logistics. According to the three major components in the reverse logistics, process are direct reuse, product recovery, and the waste management refer to the figure one, flow of the activity of the reverse logistics. These are the flow of the activity of the reverse activity are given there. Methodology. The study complies with the appropriate research methodology in order to fulfill the hallmark of the scientific research. There is extensive of the study and literature on the reverse logistics and the green logistics in the past in order to identify and review the competitive advantage in managing the reverse logistics. The author search in online database such as IMRAL and ProQuest, the general cover the period 95 to the 99 and set the relevant research keywords such as reverse logistics, return management, and the green logistics. Eventually, 20 articles were selected and grouped according to the relevance of the research review. This review is built as follows. In the next section, the discussion is on the reverse logistic concept and its scope. The definitions are extracted from a review of the past recent literature. In the second part, an overview of the ways in which the forward and reverse logistic differ is presented. Next, the author concentrated on the narrow down on the green logistic concept in comparison with the reverse logistics. Finally, the author looks into the future direction of the reverse logistics in gaining the competitive advantage. Comparison between the reverse logistics and the forward logistics. There have been very few published articles to discuss on the variation between these two logistic concepts. The next part of this assignment will present an overview of the ways in which the forward logistics and reverse logistics differ. Table to summarize the major differences between the reverse logistics and forward logistics in terms of the planning and the forecasting, product and packaging, distribution, order fulfillment speed, transportation, and total cost. The author found that the reverse logistic flow is different compared to the forward logistics in various ways. Figure 2 shows the process of the forward logistics on product and the information flow for a retail industry. Generally, in the retail industry, they depend on the sale forecast to generate the future requirement. Distribution server center plays an important role in completing the loop in retail industry. Distribution center receives and stores for the temporary before channel it out the retail stores. When the specific product is needed in the store, especially fast moving consumer goods, FMCG. The product transport direct from the distribution center to the specific retail store. Inventory visibility and forecast is important at each level to ensure the right product deliver at the right time at each store. In contrast, a reverse logistic flow is much more reactive process. It is mainly due to the less inventory visibility. Planning and decision making is much more difficult in the reverse logistic. It is fine that the planning is difficult in the case of the reverse logistic. Decision making is difficult in the case of the reverse logistic. For example, in retail industry, product return defect and the non-moving stock at the stores will return to the distribution center, which will generate the reverse logistic flow. Figure 3 shows a reverse logistic of information and product flow for the retail industry. When a consumer returns their product to a retail store, the store collects the product to be sent to a distribution center. At the time of the product return, the information about the product and its condition may be entered into the retailer's information system and forwarded to the returns processing center. According to found that the many retail companies use centralized return center to process return product. Basically, most of the distribution center should be utilized to process both forward and the reverse logistics. Most of the manufacturer take back of their product at the end of the life or when it is not required. There is also a trend lately on recall product due to the some defect such that Toyota did the recall some of their cars with defect parts. In other hand, customer normally returns the products shortly and purchase due to the poor performance in the product quality, incorrect specification, and etc. Later, this product will be collected from the respective retailer and sent to the manufacturer, vendor, or to the point of the origin where it has been produced. If there is some manufacturer in the USA implement zero return policy. The system work by the retailer is credited for the customer returns, but the return product is never physically returned to the manufacturer. Instead, the retailer disposition of the product at his facility according to the instruction of the manufacturer. The benefits of this policy are that the manufacturer avoids the product return cost, especially the transportation cost. Again, from the retailer perspective, it is additional work and their storage capability to cater the defect product. There is also some manufacturer concerns about the brand equity, which requires all the defect product from return to them, and they will determine what next cause of the action. They might rework the product, sell the product on the secondary market, recycle the product, or dispose of in the landfill. Forward logistics of the information and the product flow. This is given here, the sales forecast. Every company has to do the sale forecast. Plant shipment to the distribution center. Shipment to the distribution center. Shipment to the store. Put away store. Actual sales. Product flow is there. Information flow is there. Forward logistic information and product flow figure is given here. Product to the disposition, destination, sortation and disposition of the decision making, milk run, collection to the distribution center, collected to the store, customer returns them, return information to the distribution center, reverse logistic information and the product flow is given here. Customer returns, collected at the store, collected to the distribution center, sortation and disposition decision making, product to the disposition destination. This is known as the reverse logistics and information product flow. Major differences between the reverse logistics and the forward logistics. Reverse logistics, forward logistics. Planning and forecasting. It is more difficult in the case of the reverse logistics. In forward logistics, it is the relatively straightforward. Very good difference between the reverse logistics and forward logistics are given here. Product and packaging, not uniform, poor quality and often damaged. Here, quality and uniform is the manage. Distribution, many to one. From the many customers to the one store. This is the reverse logistics. Forward logistics, from one to many, from one store to the many customer, distribution is there. Order fulfillment speed. Speed of not considered as the priority here in case of the reverse logistics. Importance of the speed recognized. Order fulfillment. In case of the order fulfillment, in case of the forward logistics, order fulfillment is required as the customer demands. The order must be sent to them. Transportation, cost per unit higher. In case of the forward logistics, cost per unit relatively lower. Total cost, less directly visible. Closely mentioned by the accounting system. This is the total cost is there. In pointed out, the reverse logistic is not necessarily a systematic picture of the forward distribution. Table to show a comparison of the how various features of the logistic system differ or logistics and the forward logistics. Planning and forecasting. Planning for reverse logistic is more difficult than the planning for the forward logistic, due to the greater uncertainty involved in the reverse logistic. In reverse logistic, future planning and forecasting is regarded as a great challenge, and this forecast figure is needed previously, not only to determine the customer demand, but mainly before the ability of the product to be manufactured. In the retail constructs, future planning and forecasting for the reverse logistics are made difficult because individual customer ultimately hold the decision to initiate reverse logistic activity in terms of the timing and quantity. According to alike, for the forward logistics, incoming reverse logistic product is not tracked extensively because of the lack of the information system resources necessary to do this. Due to the reverse logistics product given low priority, most of the firm does not put intention or effort to manage it. it found that the lack of the information resources and the general lack of the recognition of the importance of the reverse logistic were two of the largest barrier of the reverse logistic executive cases. Product and the packaging. Complete the appropriate packaging of the new product protects it from damage. Most of the return products in the reverse logistic chain don't properly pack. Some of the return products damaged in transit due to the improper packaging or using wrong packaging material. Due to the unclear or the systematic process of the reverse logistic, the safety of the return product is not an assurance. By contrast, most products in the reverse logistic may not have complete packaging and the labeling. If the product is an unsold product coming back from the retailer, some of the packaging may have become damaged during the handling or while on the shelf, and the other packages may have been opened by the customer curious to the examine the product. Return products and an unsold product coming back from retailer have a very high percentage of the pilfering. Due to the lack of the awareness and value of the return products, the initiators seldom put minimum effort in the managing the reverse logistics. Distribution. According, one of the biggest difference between the forward logistic and reverse logistic is the number of the origin and the destination points. Whereas forward logistics is generally the movement of the product from the one origin to the many destination. The reverse movement of the product is the opposite, from many origin to the one destination. Distribution in the reverse logistic is generally small, commonly from the origin to the final destination. Reverse movement is generally from the many origin to the final destination. Order fulfillment speed. In reverse logistic, speed and urgency is not considered as priority. Many firms often consider the return on reverse product deliver or transport to the final destination. In the forward channel, it is important to fulfill a customer's order quickly to keep the customer satisfied. If the customer is not promptly served, there may be some cost incurred, but it not be directly observable. In forward logistic, the penalty to be paid for the not satisfying a customer may not be felt until much later, when the customer reduces the future order or does not order at all. By contrast, in reverse logistic, the ultimate destination for the product is back to the distribution center or the central unit return for the further action or the process. Transportation. In forward logistic, transportation could be planned so that the economic of scale and distance could be achieved. But in reverse logistic, it is much difficult. Besides that, the major cost associated with collecting a return product from a location in the transportation cost. Transportation cost for the reverse logistic per item will generally be higher than for the forward logistics. This is due in part to the fact that the reverse shipment tend to be much smaller. For example, a store may receive full truckload of the new products inbound each week, but return only one or two pallets of the reverse material in that some amount of the time. Most of the firm consolidate their return products before the transport to the final destination. Furthermore, location or origin of the return product is wide and scattered, which does not contribute to the economic of scale and the economic of the distance. Total cost. The total cost associated with the reverse logistics is not similar in the forward logistics. In forward logistics, cost is well defined and well in advance. Forward logistics generally have a systematic accounting system. It is designed to handle the comprehensive cost development for a product as it moves through the forward channel. Nevertheless, for reverse logistic, it is much difficult due to the unclear product visibility. Table 3 compares reverse logistic cost to the forward logistics. Transportation, collection, sorting, quality diagnosis, and handling are much higher compared to the forward logistic. However, inventory holding cost and the shrinkage theft much lower compared to the forward logistic. reimbursement or repackaging and change from the book value are significant for the reverse logistics. Reverse logistics from the environmental perspective. According to the reverse logistic, from the holistic environmental perspective, focuses primarily on the return of the recyclable or reusable products and material into the forward supply chain for the particular region of the reverse logistic is important for a completion of the industrial ecocycle. Figure 4 shows how reverse logistic from the environmental perspective, especially from the operational life cycle of the product. Reverse logistic supports in turn of the material reuse, remanufacturing, recycling, and disposal. The figure shown have all the material been keeping within the operational life cycle and thus minimize any flow into the external environment. The ability of the each of these services will depend on the product life cycle, industry, and design of the reverse logistic network. Product and reverse logistic figure is given here. Reverse logistic costs are there. What are the reverse logistic cost is there? Cost in comparison with the forward logistic. Transportation greater. Inventory holding cost lower. Shrinkage much lower. Obsolescence may be higher. Collection much higher and less standard. Sorting quality and diagnosis much greater. Handling much higher. Reimbursement on repackaging significant for the reverse logistic, non-existent for the forward logistic. Change from the big value significant for the reverse logistic, non-existent for the forward logistic. This is the figure of the operational life cycle of the product and reverse logistic location. Raw material is given there, virgin material is there, waste is there. Waste is there, procurement is there, reduce there, reduce the waste, reduce the waste, reduce the waste. Fabrication is there, this is the production, assembly is there, and this is the waste, distribution is there. And this is the reuse, this is the remanufacture, this is the recycle, this is the disposal. This is the reverse logistic. Assembly, user, fabrication, reduce. This is the operational life cycle of a product and the reverse logistic. This is the summary of the literature with focus on the reverse logistics. References is given here. Author is given here. Type capital is given here. Inputs is given here. Process is given here. Outputs are given here. Region for return is given here. Reverse green logistic elements, that is given here. Type is given here, capital goods and the consumer durable goods are there. Input are part, process are the manufacturing, output is the huge part, region for return, recycle, value added and extended product life cycle. Recycling, remanufacturing and the secondary market. Here is the container and the packaging material, huge container and the packaging material. Recycling is there, recycle container is there, recycling is there, recycling, reuse, packaging and the reduction is there. Papers are there, wood pulp and the waste paper. Recycling and the remanufacturing. Papers are there, recycling and reprocess. Recycling, remanufacturing and reduce environment and impact. Automobile is there, car parts is there. Recycling and remanufacturing is there. Used car parts is there. Product returns are there. Recondition and rebris is there. Secondary market is there. Catalog retailing is there. Electronic goods is there. Rework or repair is there. Electronic goods is there, product returns are there, rework or repair, and the secondary market is there. Xerox products is there. Beverage distribution is there, seller handsets are there. Xerox product is there, reversing, recycling is there. Remanufacturing and recycling is there. References are there. These are the references. these are the type is there, and these are the product and region for the return, and the reverse green logistic elements are there. Battery industry, auto parts, inputs, battery, car parts, electrical and electronic equipment, automotive, aftermarket industry, waste electronic and electronic equipment, car parts are there. Household appliances, books, auto spare parts, and pharmaceutical and the marine parts are there. Process end of the life user, remanufacturing, recycling, and the remanufacturing. These are the future direction of the research reverse logistic. There is a confusion between the reverse logistic and the green logistic because there is no clear demarcation between the both concept. Reverse logistic is commonly misleading with the green logistic concept. Redirection packaging is to use the less material or reducing the energy and the pollution from the transportation are important activity. But they might be better placed in the realm of the green logistic. If no goods or material are being sent backward, the activity probably is not a reverse logistic activity. There is a lot of the confusion and overlapping activity between the reverse logistic and the green logistic. The term green logistics is coined to refer to those practices within the supply chain and aim at reducing the resources of the waste and resources of the consumption. They are not specific to the reverse logistic process. For instance, disassembly is an operation needed within the reverse logistic before the deciding in many cases what to do afterwards. However, it will be only linked to the green logistic if the design process allowed disassembly operation to be carried out without going through the destructive operation. Figure 5 gives a brief comprehension of the reverse logistic and green logistics in terms of the activity based. Reverse logistics, green logistics. Reverse logistic, product returns, market return, secondary market. Recycling, remanufacturing, reusable packaging. Green logistic, packaging reduction, air and noise emission, environmental impact on mode selection. Comprehension of the reverse logistics are given here. Comprehension of the reverse logistics and green logistics are the completely given here. Green logistics, packaging reduction, air noise emission, environmental impact on the mode selection is there. This is a green liquid, a green logistics. Also is there recycling, remanufacturing, reusable packaging. Reverse logistic product returns, marketing returns, secondary markets. These are the reverse logistics. Discussion. In final part of this literature review, the author summarizes all 15 articles and break down based on the product type, inputs and process output, region for the return and the elements of the reverse or green logistics referred in the table 4. The summary was used to discuss further on each of the reverse logistic issue and the findings. Planning and forecasting. The author identified generally planning and forecasting is much difficult in the reverse logistic due to the uncertainty. However, the author concludes it is vital to all firms to manage the reverse logistic and its gives significant in detail. Besides that, the firm should integrate the existing IS in managing the reverse logistics or expand the existing IS to the cover the reverse logistic activity. All level of the firm should understand the importance of the reverse logistic by educate and continuous training and most of all. Suit to the organization culture and importance of managing reverse or green logistic in environment sustainability. Product and packaging. Proper packaging and using the right packaging material is the required in the managing the product in the reverse logistic. Most of the return products have the some economic value. Besides that, it is important to properly manage due to the environment concern. Some of the return products are dangerous goods which require a specific packaging and disposal method. Lately, most of the country in the world emphasize the importance of the following the Environment Act and standard in handling and dispose of the dangerous goods. The author suggests the need for the clear environment, standard and matrices used in the managing and evaluate the reverse logistics and the green logistics. Distribution. Reverse logistics involve reverse product from the origin to the final destination. Due to the reverse movement is from the many origin to the final destination, it is involved mainly transportation movement and which does not contribute to the economics of sale and economic of distance. Most of the organization consolidates the return products movement to the reduce their transportation cost. There is a new trend involved whereby the firms outsource to the third party logistics service provider in collecting and dispose of the return products. In some retailing outlets, the origin equipment manufacturer give compensation to the retail outlet to carry out the dispose at their points or restore to avoid all necessary movement and the cost. Proper planning and the coordination required in managing the reverse logistics, especially in the transportation movement. It could be achieved by the integrate the IS to the transport management. The final receiving site such as a distribution center or the central unit return should have adequate storage to accommodate the return product from the channel. For this remanufacturing product, it is recommended to immediate start the process to avoid any more product depreciation value and the product deterioration. Order fulfillment speed. In most of the article, the firm of put less priority and urgency in handling reverse or the return product. The authority identify there is four reasons why the firms put less priority and urgency in handling the reverse of the return product. Depends on the product characteristics such as components, parts, high value or the perishable goods. Aftermarket value contributes to the preserve environment sustainability, compatibility with the legislation. Next is the transportation. It is important to all firms plan their reverse transport movement to achieve maximum in economic of scale and economic of distance. Time, quantity, and the quality and certainty in acquisition are non-critical factors for the reverse logistic transportation. The author find out that the trade-off between the environmental benefits of the recycling versus the extra transportation cost has not been established. It is preferable to bring together both economic and environment aspect in planning for the reverse transportation. Total cost. Basically, the author find out it is much difficult to define and know in advance reverse logistic total cost. Most of the cases so that the firm difficult to identify the total cost involved in the reverse logistic due to the unclear product visibility and uncertainty in the product return. It is important to the every firm to acknowledge the significant cost involved in the manufacturing reverse logistics. These costs generally have to be trade off with the recycling and the environmental benefits. Finally, we discuss about the conclusions. In the nutshell, most of the organizations have considered the importance of the reverse logistics as a competitive advantage. Every company has to follow the reverse logistics. Besides that, by managing the reverse logistics, there is the few process and activity which act of the guideline to the organization to follow which had significant of the cost and the manpower to the firm. Thus, there are also trends whereby some organization outsource reverse logistic function and concentrate in their core business. The above discussion reflects that the reverse logistics is a complex and a dynamic process and not merely a reversal of the direction of the supply chain. It involves tremendous planning and requires diligent commitment, not only from the indigenous party, that is the business unit along the initial supply chain, but also from the third party logistic provider and the government. Without the direct involvement of an entire organization, the whole process of the reverse logistic and its strategy will become cumbersome and unresponsive. Moreover, with the emergence of the e-commerce and the ever-increasing willingness of the consumer to the return goods, come the need to the rethink the significance of the reverse logistics management. This has also given rise to the development and incorporation of the reverse logistics strategy in their business model with the expectation to the gain, cost, effectiveness, and the competitive advantage. And the references are given here. R3 and dot tree. Clandian dot tree. There was Lasty, Flapper, Glean, Goldsby, and Cross, Guide, Hanafi, Ibrahim, Kanan, Krikal, Kroon, Midi, Midi and Circus, which is very important, Midi and Circus. Molenkov, Mortich, Murphy and Poest, Odrami, B. Ravi and the Ravi Shankar. देखो है कि नहीं रवि शंकर का नाम है कि नहीं. Rogers, Rogers DS, Rogers DS, Silver, Silver and Pike, Joliet and Ibrahim, Tibbon and Lembark and Rogers, Tari and Sundaram and Rajgopal, Sundaram and BK and Skinner. Here is the most important paper, is the B. Ravi and the Ravi Shankar, reverse logistic operation in the paper industry, a case study, Journal of the Advances in the Management Research, volume 3, number 2, PP 8894 and the 206. This is the most important paper for the reverse logistic.